Hello, my friends. This is Kachi, aka Delacaba, here with a new Ice Lakes video. We have just had ourselves a massive update, and I am just so excited I could squirt. I tell you what, because I have made a multitude of requests for some very specific things to help bring this ice fishing game into the possibility of having a North American ice fishing experience. Because you see, the thing is that the game initially, of course, has been very Eurocentric, so the baits and the fish and everything have been very much European baits and fish. Well, they have just given us a buttload of new content. We've got three new species: bluegills, black crappie, and flounder. They've given us two new maps, which are North American inspired maps. They have given us a bunch of new bait. They have given us just, why should I sit here and talk about it when I can show you? So let's take a look here. So the first thing is when we come to jigs, what we're going to find is that number one, we have two brand new situations going on. We've got ourselves these lovely spinners, which they have added for us. All right. As well as giving us these spoons. And so these are brand new for us, just a whole new collection. And I'll tell you what, there's some good looking baits. You'll see here, rated for bluegill. Very, very well done. Now, the second thing is in our more traditional baits, our more mishkas, as well as our balanced jigs, what they've done is they've put in some jigs that are aimed very specifically towards certain species. So, for instance here, I've got my classic crazy catch here. You know, best for roach, bream, and perch. Good for pike, chub, thrush, and carp. But if we go here to the top end baits, and for instance, we look here at the dimensional rift, good for salmon. All right. I mean, it also works with other species, but it's very specifically aimed toward catching salmon. With the gecko here for brook trout, the dawn of dusk for pike, which is one I've definitely got on my list for future baits. And the same thing here. Now, what's kind of cool is I've got my green goblin. All right. And I've been fishing this green goblin as my primary balanced lure for a long time, because it's good for pike and whitefish and brook trout and a number of other things. And the thing is that we've got a new green goblin here, which is best for bluegill. So I'm not sure how that's going to work out, just because I'm definitely eventually going to get that green goblin for the bluegill. But so along with some very specific and new mermishkas and balanced and those new lures, we've also got new baits. They have paid attention to the North American fishermen, and they have given us dough balls, the larvae of drone flies, Chronomidae larvae, and quite frankly, I'm a little startled by the fact that they're saying that they're good for pike. That's a little odd, got to tell you. But then we've also got small fish, which of course are minnows, and we've got shrimps. The other thing they've done is they've coordinated the color between the standard baits here, the larva, all right, and our lures. All right, so if we look here, trout jam, our green lure, all right, for asp, perch, and rainbow trout, roach, bream, and whitefish, and we come on up here and we look at our green fly larva, asp, perch, and rainbow trout, roach, bream, and whitefish. All right, so they've color coordinated these guys, which is absolutely brilliant. Now, we've got, let's see, good for roach, perch, bream, good for, I'm looking for the bluegill one. That's what I want. All right. None of these seem particularly geared towards bluegill. Let's take a look here. Drone fly. I'm really kind of surprised, because drone fly larva is, I mean, really, really aimed strongly towards bluegill and crappie. But what we're going to do is enough jibber jabber. We do not have any new hooks, nor do we have any new equipment this way. All right. But what we're going to do is, I think we're going to go to one of our two new lakes. Hardy Herrings Canal is one of the new lakes, as well as Clear Waters. And I think what we're going to do is we're going to go to Clear Waters. We're going to set up to fish morning. We're going to set our fishing time for 10 minutes because we don't have a whole lot of time here. In fact, what we'll do is we'll set it up for 15 minutes because that's about what we've got left here. And we're going to come fish this. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to get real specific here. All right, so what we need to do is we need to head on out here and we're going to try one of the new fish houses. I think we're going to go for this blue guy because it's towards a little bit shallower water. And you just come up to the fish house and you'll see when you mouse over it, you get a blue highlight around it. Just give it a click, you'll walk right in, and you will drop your line down. Now I'm fishing a shallow sandy bottom here, which is going to be good, or should, if it's like the real world, should be good for black crappie especially, but also bluegill. And so what we're going to do is we're going to set up with our ultralight rod. Alright, we're going to set up with a Mermishka because you cannot fish balanced lures on the Mermishka. And I'm going to use the Rainbow Bash. And the reason I'm going to use the Rainbow Bash is because it is very good for bluegill. In fact, it's aimed specifically at bluegill. We are going to go to our dough balls for bait because that's also very strong towards bluegill. And we are going to be using our brown does because they're also good for bluegill. So you can see we're set up all the way across the line here for bluegill. So we're going to drop our brown doe down there and we're going to let fly. Let's see what we can do. Now fishing the ultralight, any contact at all, it'll really show. And we're going to use a nice, steady, constant motion. And that should entice them little buggers like crazy. Now for panfish, I have a tendency to use a steady, slow, side to side. For predatory fish, I have a tendency to use a up and down. A flounder. Hello, Mr. Flounder. That's one of our new fishes. Gotta say, I'm a little surprised to see flounders in North American waters. We do have a little bait on there, but I'm going to bait fresh. There we go. Drop her on down. Come on, Mr. Bluegill. So the biggest thing is when you're using an up and down motion on this ultralight rod, you see you get a lot of bounce in it. That's why a nice slow steady side to side is a good way to go with the ultralight rod, simply because you're not going to get bounce that you're going to take false feedback off of. Wow, there we got a real fish. Black crappie. Ooh, a pike. How in the hell did we catch a pike on there? That was a surprise. Well, I'm not going to complain. And look at that, our bait is still solid. We're going to drop it right back down there. That was a bit of a surprise, got to say. Was not expecting to see a pike on there. I thought maybe we had a nice black crappie on there. But if there's pike down there, one would expect there'd be bluegill. We got good shallow water. But the ultralight rod is really nice because any contact at all, and it'll give you a good bounce. This rod will be much too light to take up a big pike. Come on, where are the bluegills? Another flounder. All right. We're going to give her one more swing here, and then I think we'll change locations because I'm looking for them bluegills. Remember, you got to bait your hook up. There we go. Get that feller down there. With all this specificity for bluegills, I'm really kind of surprised we're catching flounder and pike. But the ultralight rod is an excellent investment, especially if you're doing contests where the focus is the maximum number of fish. Alright, so we're picking up nothing but flounder here. So what we're going to do is pull up stakes and we're going to move to another location here. Look for another shallow location. But we're going to hop on out of here. And we've had two new character models, and I've got this new feller here because, well, quite frankly, he's got a real beard. Let's run on over here to this brown shack. This one available? Yep, it is. Ooh, in fact, that shack right on over there. That brown one right there. That could be our winner. Come on in here. We're gonna see if we can get us some bluegillies. I'd like to catch at least one black crappie and one bluegill just so we can get a look at the new models here. Alright, let's dump her on down there and let fly. This is nice and shallow, sandy bottom. There's no reason at all why we shouldn't be picking up bluegill and picking up black crappie. I can complain about catching... Ooh, there's a good fish. And it's a pike. Well, I'm not going to complain. That's going to help us towards winning the contest, but... Like I say, kind of a surprise. Bait that guy up. There we go. Drop her on down. Nice thing about shallow water fishing is even a big fish you can bring up fast. You know, if you're fishing deep water and you get a 15-pound pike on there, it can take a good long time to get it up and out of the water. There we go. See who we got here. Oh, I was too slow. But our bait's still there, so we'll drop her right back down again. But, you know, you catch a real heavy fish like a 15-pound pike. In fact, my last fishing trip, I took a 15-pound pike here in the game. You know, you may wonder why it is that I've got the largest size hole drilled here, but it's because fishing side-to-side motion, that's expanding my range of motion substantially. And that means I've got that Mermishka moving around a good range of distance down there. Let's rebait that guy. We could fish just fine with the amount of bait we had on there, but a full bait should increase your chances of picking up a fish. Oh, fishes. We got 7 minutes left here. There's a good fish. Line broke. In fact, that was a good enough fish that it broke our line. Alright, one more time. I may switch over to some bigger rig and go out to some deeper water, see if we can just get us a real good big fish to win the contest here. But that is the risk with the ultralight setup. If you tie into a big one, he'll snap your line. And another flounder, so we're just floundering around right now. See what I did there? Alright, well, what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to switch back over to my heavy classic. Gonna get me rigged with my green goblin. And this is the classic green goblin, not the new bluegill green goblin. And gonna switch on over to, I think, the old golden balls, right? No, what is it? Sharky, that's the one, isn't it? No. Not trout jam. Is it sparkle night? Huh. Well, we'll just go with what we got. What the hell? Toss this guy down there. There's a fish down there big enough to break my line. Let's see if we can bring him in. In the shallow water, we actually might pick up some black crappie getting on this combination rig like this in shallow water. Our balance jig. There's a chance. There's a real good chance we could pick up black crappie. Because crappie will take a balanced jig. But you notice I can do my up and down motion here. And I don't get a bunch of bounce. Let's see what we got here. Probably another flounder. I bet you they'll take this just as well. That's all right. All right, what do we got? 5-16, huh? We're going to pull up stakes. And we're going to head for some deeper water, see if we can pick us up a big fish, really tap out this situation. I think because we're short on time, we'll come to this one here. It's relatively close to our finish line. Ah, yes, thermos of good old-fashioned coffee right there to keep us warm. I like the fact that in the fish houses, we don't have to constantly be de-icing our holes, and that is fantastic. There we go. Drop that down there and drop that down there. We're actually going to pull her down deeper. We're still set at the same depth as we were for the previous hole, so we're going to pull her down deep. There we go. Let's hope we can pick up a great big old pike. We're going to fish her up and down and fish her side to side, and we're just going to switch back and forth between the two motions. But using the largest drill gives us a real big hole, and that means when we fish a slow side to side like this, we're getting a big range of motion. For a second, I thought we had one fiddling, but if it was, he was awful tiny. But the Mormishkas, a slow, constant movement is a real good way to go. When you're fishing the balance jigs and you want to pique the interest of the predators, the up and down work like this definitely seems to be the way to go. There we go. See what we got here. Probably another flounder. There seem to be a lot of flounder, and I'm really kind of surprised there's so many flounder in North American water. I was too slow. Get on down there, you. We got to win this contest. I got to earn me some monies so I can get some of these new lures, try them out. I had just enough tucked away to grab some of the new baits and a new Mormishka. But I'd sure like to get that new peacock or maybe the new green goblin. Though I don't know if our game would kind of get confused by the fact that I've got the old school green goblin and the new school green goblin. But it's very, very thoughtful of the developers not to just take a lure that we already had and have been fishing with for a long time and decide to just, up and switch what it does. So I'm glad that they let me keep my old greenie, because the green goblin has been my friend. Come on, fish. You bastards, you. Mighty slow here. Yeah, I know. There he is. Here's a real fish. See, it's going to take us a long time to bring him up, and that tells me that this is a fairly weighty fish. I doubt he's a 15-pounder, but I guarantee you he's a good one. Probably a big old pike. A monster flounder, a 5.87-pound monster flounder. How about them apples? Well, we're going to put our line back in the water for, about 40 seconds here. But you can see a real heavy fish. It takes a long time to bring him up. And that's perfectly okay, because that's realistic. When you got a good heavy fish on there and you're bringing that line up by hand, and it can be a fight. We're going to push to 45 seconds. If we don't catch a fish real, real soon, we're gonna have to bail. If we do catch a fish, if he's a big one, we may miss our time marker. Gotta giddy up, go. But with this last flounder, that should put us pretty good. We're going to have to run like hell here. Let's go. All right. Let's see what we got. Sublimo, there we go. Got us, wow, 1075. It's not quite enough for me to get that new green goblin, but I'm getting a whole lot closer. But there you go, guys. So with this new update, they've added in a very North American ability. The ability to have a very North American experience. And I am looking forward now to playing the game much more. I kind of held off. I knew there was the big update coming up, and I've had an awful lot of other stuff to do and to play. So thank you for joining me, Delakabov, for a quick review of the new Ice Lakes update. We won us a contest, got us some new gear, and I'm looking forward to seeing you guys next time. So I'm going to get on out of here, and remember, if you're going to be a bear, be a grizzly.